Ya Peter Abdul Qadir Jilani, Ya Ali, Ya whoever.
Yeah, who finishes in this? What do you follow?
Allah is saying in the verse, Allah is real.
It's even other guys, I thought it was just Ali.
Trying to make us like some tech fairies, you see what I'm saying?
No, I'm asking you, bro. I never said anything clear.
When I said the camouflages, I'm saying, this is what I said. When you have rappers like Stormzy and Snoop and stuff, it's not a threat because you know they can fall.
Boy, shut up.
But when you have, that was poor. Oh, man didn't do it. Oh, man didn't do it. And I need to do it. And if you say they did, you're lying upon them. So you can pray to a stone, you can pray to an idol, you can pray to whatever.
Exactly.
Put in the path of the Sunnah and the Salaf is clear. You want to be on this other praying to Jesus, Buddha, Ali, I don't know, shake this and shake that.
We're talking about cities.
Spread in a lot of places in Somalia. And we're doing a day, inshallah, with partners. We can talk about the history of Somalia. I'm going to invite you to be
there. Not if Abu Layf is going to be there.
No, not Abu Layf. Yeah, Abu Layf. It's not
Somalia. What is that talk about anyway? You done with Abu Layf?
I'll show you guys.
Abu Layf's on a joke, bro. What's he on?
I don't agree with you.
Tank top shit.
We're gonna have to wear no kameez.
That's his boy. He's got bad gel in his hair. It's like that.
Anyway, let's talk. So we're having the Somali day, yeah? Well, we're gonna get mainly Somali speaking about like Pakistanis like me. We're gonna learn about the history of Somalia, yeah? It's a great
thing.
But within that, right? In Somalia, there's a big sweep in history.
There is.
You have to acknowledge that.
We follow the Shafi.
Exactly. The Shafi is great. So I follow some of the Sufi scholars that I follow, like the Ba'alawis. I don't know if you heard of Yemen. A lot of the Somali brothers that I chill with, they follow the Ba'alawi Tariqa. Yemen and Somalia.
A lot of Somalis that you chill with follows that.
Have you heard of Brebanese? So I used to go to Brebanese.
I'm a Somali.
Yeah.
We're 100% Sunni.
So are they.
If he's not a Muslim, he'll probably be a Christian guy that came here, wanted to drink and do his things.
Now he left Islam. Yeah.
But I will never see Somali.
Wallahi, bro. These are some of the most beautiful brothers that you've ever seen Somali brothers. Wallahi. This was a must that we're going to do.
So basically, look at this verse. Look what he's saying, Ramadan. Ya Ali is invoking. You know what invoking means?
Yeah, of course. You don't believe that Ali, radiallahu ta'ala,
when you say
does it make a difference? No. You're calling upon Ali or calling upon another person. Does it make a difference? Is that person, does he change something?
No, we say.
If you call upon Ali or you call upon this guy right here, does it change something?
They can't do anything.
Okay, so
we say that they have a maqam, a certain rank of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask for your blessings, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is just.
So it does make a difference because it's invoking Ali.
And I understand your opinion.
The
reason why you call it
Ali, the Prophet's state is higher than Ali.
Because you think Ali makes a difference.
Yes. So if you're going to vote anybody, we're not supposed to vote nobody, but if you're going to vote anybody, it's supposed to be vote, stop for Allah. We know that.
What he's saying, whatever you call upon, it doesn't change nothing. If Allah intended you something, he can't change anything. Wallahi, this is what he's saying, clear cuts.
Rap Raven. Yes, brother. The most intellectual black guy on road.
MashaAllah.
Yeah, he's
Real brother, man. When are you going to come to the side, man? When are you coming,
yeah,
man? The Lions, man. When are you coming?
Good, yeah.
This is good, man. Evidence.
No. What are you looking for?
Well, like, this is basically saying, yeah? The person that you're invoking cannot change
what,
nothing.
What, for the phone?
Are you just calling me now? Call the phone, Ali changes everything. You just said it, brother. I told you, if you call upon this guy right here, and you call it,
I don't think Ali can
give you a benefit. No, brother, I told you, look, the reason why you call upon Ali instead of this guy right here, Ali makes a difference. It makes a difference. And I told you, this verse says, whoever you call upon, they don't make no difference. If Allah intended you harm, you get harm. If Allah intended you mercy, this is what the verse says.
We should that.
So Ali, whoever you call us,
you're saying
I agree with that, and it goes against me.
So it's 38.
Surah 39. Ayah 38.
Aki, we shouldn't even be having these conversations, because in the Ummah, we know this is a deviation. There's no difference between Christians praying to Jesus and having this conversation.
No, this is how Aiden is.
The whole reason why the Prophet came is that Quraysh of the Prophet's time, they were not atheists. They believed in Allah. The problem was is that they used to have idols, and they didn't believe. Even in hard times, they used to turn to Allah. Yes. The problem was is that they used to use them as intercessors. This was the whole point of the dawah. It's not that they were atheists. They didn't believe in Allah. It wasn't that they worshipped these things as the main god and this, that, and the other.
They were better than the Shia.
Yeah. Because in times of hard,
wallahi, they were better than
Shia. Can I just finish?
As if they're dying, they call upon Ali.
Okay.
The Meccan pagans, if they're dying, they call upon Allah.
Exactly.
Look at the difference. Wallahi, they're better.
They get the excuse of ignorance and stuff like that, but they're ulama, kafarain. The ones that make sure we don't make tafsir of them as lay people. Yeah, you get the benefit of being a lay Ashari or a lay thingy or being Muslim, because we can't make tafsir of you. We can't make tafsir of people. That's the only lesson.
It's tafsir of it. It doesn't say the verse.
What was it?
Verse
38. Yeah. And if they were to ask,
exactly. But brothers, all I'm trying to say is, we're not in doubt about this thing. Maybe an Ashari is, maybe a Shia, isn't it? But we all know the reason why we're Muslim and we're not Christians. You pray to Jesus, you pray to Buddha, you pray to some other.
See, this is exactly what I was saying, yeah?
Can I finish, please? Yeah. I finish and I'll go. So what I'm trying to say to you, we don't need to do this. I don't know why people, like all these people, are on tight TV. You know, it's on tight TV. It's always deviant Muslims, but Ashari, Shiites, and this, that, and the other. And so forth. So the whole thing is this. Yes, Ashari. Ashuris are. I'm not talking about you because you might be ignorant. But the ulama, the Ashuris and Shia,
I love it.
But the whole thing is, come to the Sunnah, we could be like, we can have some more love. But the thing is this, praying to Buddha, praying to Jesus, praying to Gandhi or whatever.
Gandhi.
It's the same thing. Praying to Allah, it's the same thing. We say Iyakana Buddha, where Iyakana stay. We don't say it for chalk. We say 17 times a day, because the difference between a Muslim and a Quraysh was that they used to use the idols or intercessors. Now man say, no, do you know what? Hold on. So now, you may have Muslims in 2008 and say, yeah, you can. We say Yakina Budu, where Yakina staying, but it doesn't really mean that. You can pray to this saint, you can pray to this prophet, you can pray to that. At the end of the day, we follow the prophet. We never found after the prophet died, yes, that Abu Bakr, and if you say that they did, you're lying upon them, that they used to pray to them in the grave and say, oh Muhammad, please Allah, ask Allah for this. Abu Bakr never did it, Omar didn't do it, Uthman didn't do it, and Ali didn't do it. And if you say they did, you're lying upon them. So you can pray to a stone, you can pray to an idol, you can pray to whatever. Following the path, the Sunnah and the Salaf is clear. You want to be on this other, praying to Jesus, Buddha, Ali, I don't know, shake this and shake that, you could do it. As Sunnis and Salafis, we're clear about it. If you're in doubt, if you want to be a Titan TV regular goer, and Shia and Ashiris, look, you can't get Muslims on there that are Sunni or Salafi, yeah? So you have to get. This is passion. But if you worship, pray. If you pray to man,
continue.
But if you pray to man, you might get a bit agitated, yes? If you're making dua to Allah, but sometimes shake this and shake that, you might be a bit agitated. But that's what I'm saying.
Could you be wrong?
Hold on. Okay, no, I can't be wrong. No.
Look what Allah says, yeah? Shall I tell you what Allah says?
So I end this and I'm chip off. You'll find on Titans TV, Shiites, Asharis, all family with Kalam hanging out and just being buddies. You know why? Because they can't.
You've been watching Titan TV, bro.
I apologize for being emotional, but the whole thing is, shake a woman's hand. No, of course you can't. It's haram.
I'll shake a nun right now.
You know what? It's like Dean Squad and all these guys, yeah? So you have all these people.
Dean Squad.
Hold on.
I never said anything clear.
When you have rappers like Stormzy and Snoop and stuff, it's not a threat because you know they're kafar.
Oh boy, shut up.
But when you have, that was poor. But when you
do that, that's a good joke. You know that's a good joke.
Minus 5 out of 10. Listen, anyway, so I'm just saying, but when you have someone like Dean Squad, we put a camouflage on, this is religious. This is a good thing. It confuses because they're speaking about Hajj, they're speaking about this, that, and the other.
People think Drake is haram, but then Dean Squad is halal.
Yeah, it's
this.
Exactly.
It's confusing people.
In Somalia,
right now, look, bro, hear this. If I'm Somalian, if I listen to music in Somalia, if I listen to hip hop, they'll tell me, Astaghfirullah. But then listen to the music, singing in Somali. That's fine.
Have you been to a Somali wedding, bro? No one could be.
That was my house growing up, bro.
Yo, it's haram.
So now we've got Muslims trying to follow the Salah. Trying to follow the Salah. It's clear to us. Iyakana buduwa, iyakana stay. You know what I'm saying? Kitab at-Tawheed. You know what I'm saying? We're trying to follow the deen. Then we got Muslims coming along. Do you know what? It's not really shirk. It's not really bad if you make dua to righteous sakes. Do you know what I'm saying? It's not really that. So what's the difference between
they
us?
Come with that. It's a difference of opinion. Shirk is a difference of opinion.
Why is he there? He's here for reading.
So we're reading
through the tafsir. He's trying to explain to you
what it's called. So there's many differences.
I'll bring you a tafsir. I don't know whose tafsir that is.
It's not in the Quran. It's got Imam Qurtubi. It's got Imam Zamakhshari. It's got Imam Tabari.
So the verse was, and we
ask them who created the heavens and the earth. They will surely say God. Say then you have considered those upon you call apart from God. Yeah. If God desires some harm for me, could they remove His harm? And if He desires for some mercy, could they withhold His mercy? Say God suffices for me. In Him we trust. I don't disagree with this, absolutely. So that's what you want, yeah? So, the classical tafsir, it talks about when questioning the sources of creation, so we have to look at all the idolatrous, the Quraysh, so we know it's the Quraysh, yeah? They will say this to God, and it gives you loads of references, Quran ayah 10, 31, Quran ayah 23, 84, Quran ayah 29, 61, so that contextualizes what they're talking about, yeah? Because of the agency, a creator above the heaven is evident to them, so meaning there was a higher God giving them what they still believe in one supreme deity, but they had the head of a pantheon. So
did you see that?
They still believe in one supreme deity, but they still believe in one supreme deity.
But that's what you believe. The Quraysh always believe that.
Pantheon is different. So pantheon is thought. Pantheon is thought. This is what pantheon is. pantheon is like, so you've got loads of many different gods, and you can independently ask them.
Yeah.
So they're not relying on Allah, they're relying on the independent.
Are you doing that with Ali? The same thing.
Here's the difference. We're not asking Ali, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, karamallahu wajhahu, independently. We say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah's permission that soul can hear us, and we ask Ali.
What do you say exactly? So, say, Ya Ali, what would you say? And then we can.
Then
we can get down to
the say, Ya Ali, that's it.
Guys, I thought it was just Ali. There's even other guys.
Oh, Sufis,
you don't know, stop that one thing.
We don't believe those that they can independently. We say through your closeness to Allah, because you're awliya, which is mentioned also in the Quran, then you can ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on our behalf. That's not to say that we don't independently ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
You're doing
atawassul.
Yeah,
atawassul.
But Allah said in that verse I gave you, and
the
person that you're calling
is that allowed?
You don't change anything.
And your Lord said, call upon me, I will answer you.
Yes.
He didn't say call up to other people.
But it doesn't negate
you. No problem. Yeah. You sin us, right?
No.
Okay, what about this ayah? إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي. Those who are proud to call on me and singing me out.
So you sing.
Yes. Look at this ayah.
You sing me out, God.
There's too many.
Hold it down.
Look at this ayah. I'm going to read this ayah, bro.
This ayah.
You
see the difference, bro.
It's a worship.
We're going to make dua to someone else.
No, listen. We're going to not make dua to someone else. Listen. Let me say this one thing. Look at this last ayah. Look at this
last ayah. Last ayah.
And it's good that we're having these discussions.
MashaAllah, bro. It's going to shut down the game. Listen. If you invoke them, they hear not your call. And if they were to hear, they could not grant it to you. And on the day of resurrection, they will disown your worship in them. Allah calls it worshiping them.
No. This is about idols,
bro. It's not about idols, it's about invoking. It's about
idols.
Actually, it's about invoking.
This is about idols.
This is about idols.
Ali is allowed. Ali, what did you do?